Yo, what is poppin', my beautiful people? Today, I thought I'd do something a little bit different than my i7 video. Plus, I'll give you guys some updates, but today I'm going to be doing my top 3 tier 10 heavy tanks. Now, obviously, this is kind of based off of playstyle and really just personal preference, but I will, like, if you want to go down to the comments and leave me your suggestions or ideas on what your top 3 are, I love to hear them. I just want to hear them. Anyway, some updates. For my how to plays, I figured the best way to do that is I'll just start at my tier 10s and I'll just go left to right, and then we'll go down to tier 9 and tier 8, etc. Which means I will be having a how to play on the Sheridan coming out very soon. Really, what's scheduled now is this video, my top 3, and then I will have a map Monday, the first of it, where I'll be going over the map Abbey, as well as the patch notes for Tuesday, talking about the T57 heavy buffs. Anyway, let's get into this video, and I'm actually going to start off with some honorable mentions. Alright, and we're here with honorable mention number 1. It is the AMX 50B, not even a heavy tank. Anyway, the reason I put this at a heavy tank, if you've played this game for a year or less, or maybe a little bit more than that, this might have been a medium tank to you, but on PC, and ever since this tank came out, it was a heavy tank. It's an absolute beast with its speed, its gun. Armor, not so great, except its frontal hull. So auto-aiming on this thing is actually very difficult. But yeah, its speed is absolutely insane. It's got one of the best guns, if not the best, of the tier 10 heavy tank autoloaders. And also another thing, there will be no gameplay in this video, so if you are here for gameplay, I don't blame you for clicking off, but pretty much it'll be in the how to plays once I do get to these tanks, starting from left to right. Anyway, yeah, that's the 50B as honorable mention number 1. Let's get to honorable mention number 2. All right, and we're here with honorable mention number 2. It is the Kranvaan. The reason I put the Kranvaan up here is, yeah, its gun is a little, I would say, derpy. It doesn't really like, it likes to troll with you a little bit, but it does make up for it with its outrageous turret armor and 12 degrees of gun depression, making this thing an absolute ridgeline beast. Absolute beast, you know what I'm saying? If you can just get past the gun, this thing, how fast does it go? It goes 60 forward. That's actually a lot. I thought it went like 45 or 50, but yeah, it goes 60 forward. It's got really good speed, especially for a tier 10 heavy. But yeah, that's honorable mention number 2. Let's get to our last and final honorable mention. And for our final honorable mention, it is the Super Conqueror. Now, I have one main reason for putting the Super Conqueror in an honorable mention is just because of how user-friendly the tank is. Oops, pressed the wrong button there. The Super Conqueror is a great tank to learn the aim at. If you're still trying to choose what line to go down and you're using this video as a guide, the Super Conqueror is very, very new player-friendly. It's a very easy tank to play. It's very generic for its class. It plays like most heavies do. It's got a very strong turret. It's got a weak point on top that's kind of hard to hit and a little trollish at times, but it's got an amazing gun. It's not the slowest thing, and it really just has, it's all around good at everything. It really does what the E5 could do better. It does what the 2 and 5B could do better. Yeah, Super Conk comes in at honorable mention number 3. So without ado, let's get into our full list, starting with number 3. So, with number 3, we are actually staying in the same branch. We are going to go to the Chieftain Mark VI. Now, the Chieftain Mark VI actually came out while I was in boot camp. And I didn't find out until 6 or 7 weeks when I got out that this tank was added to the game. And it surprised me. I mean, even PC YouTubers jumped on this thing. Yeah, it's an absolute menace to society. This thing, if played right, can just annihilate an enemy team. So with it fully equipped, I've got this thing over 4,000 average damage per minute, which is absolutely just nuts. The gun on this thing is ridiculous. It's not the fastest, of course, but 46 will still be able to get you around quick enough. The gun, without, like, just look at that, 0.25 accuracy, 10.23 rate of fire, 5.87 reload time, absolutely nuts. The only problem I've ever found myself having in this tank is I actually do tend to get ammo racked quite. I just feel like I get Amoraked more frequently if I can find it here. Yeah, it's right there in the front. So on either side. So if they do hit clean middle shots, easy. But yeah, I do find my Amoraked getting hit a lot, and you'll see that in the how to play when I go over my crew skills and my equipment. But as you can see there, I do have the Amoraked crew skill for my crew there. But yeah, the Chieftain comes in at number 3. So let's get to number 2. And coming in at number 2 is the WZ1115A, the Tier 10 Chinese heavy tank. This thing has actually been in the game for a while, and whenever I was doing esports and GTL, the 5A replaced the IS-7 very quickly when it was added. It's just an absolute beast of a tank. And as I'm on this thing, I'll talk about there's not going to be any premiums. I might just do a separate list for that, but because the Quillen would outright beat this thing in a fair fight, I think. But yeah, this is just a smaller version of the Quillen, but it's tech tree. Anyway, the 5A packs a big punch with 490 alpha. See why it replaced the IS-7 with 3800 DPM. So you're only dropping off, what, 300 and some change off the Chieftain, which is really, really good. 0.3 accuracy for a 440 alpha is really good. Aiming time, not so great. 2200 hit points. I mean, it is what it is. It does go 50 forward, which is very, very good. But another thing that you'll see common, it has a very powerful turret able to use hills. I'm not sure the gun depression is that great. Yeah, only sitting at 7. But I personally, in my opinion, think it is a better tank than the Chieftain. I've never been a fan of the Chieftain, but I mean, it's still a great tank. So is the 5A. Anyway, let's get to our number 1 spot. And I'm sure most people can figure out what it is. Yep, and you probably guessed it. Number 1 right now is the VZ-55, the most recent addition to the World War II tech tree. Yeah, it's an absolute beast on PC. And whenever it joined our ranks, it's absolutely nuts. It gets 2 selective guns. It gets gets 2 130s. One, so as you can notice, there's a muzzle brake. That means it's a single fire. The other one has no muzzle brake. That means it's a double fire gun. And I personally like to use the double fire over the single fire. However, the single fire is a viable option depending on your playstyle. But I personally do like the double barrel, like that quick burst of nearly 1,000 damage every time. Because it does get a very good intra-clip reload with 2 seconds. That's not bad at all. 2.4 aiming time with 0.3 accuracy, and 17.38 reload time. That is very good. Its DPM is lacking, but I would much rather take the 1,000 damage burst over DPM. Let's actually see the DPM with the other gun. So with the other gun, you're actually gaining about 200, if I remember correctly, 3322 compared to, what was it, like 3080 something? Oh man, I'm messing up here. Yeah, 3033. So yeah, you're gaining about 200 hit points on your DPM, which, I mean, is compared to our other tanks in the list, isn't that great? But that burst damage compared with this turret armor and its absolutely menacing speed of 50 forward is just nuts. I think the only thing that really lets this thing down is it only gets 2100 hit points, which really isn't that great. And its penetration is a little subpar, but it does get 8 degrees of gun depression. Absolutely insane, this tank is. Yep, for all of these tanks, if you're looking for some gameplay, they will be coming with the how to plays, which I'll be trying to release weekly, as well as Map Monday. I'll be going over maps and how I play them. Another thing is for the how to plays, I'm no expert. Like the IS-7, I would consider myself an expert in, but whenever it comes to tanks like the Sheridan, I'm really just going to go over how I play the tank and what I run and show you some gameplay. But don't take the how to plays as in a straight up guide, because I am not an expert. By all means, in every single tank. Other than that, I should be having a video coming out. I should have 2 videos coming out on Monday. Other than that, let's hit him with the outro. I'm running out of time. Every day goes by so fast. And every moment counts, baby. I don't want to miss a thing. We can sleep under the stars, we can sleep under the stars, or hang out in hotel bars, driving somewhere in your car. We can sleep under the stars.